Yes, sir.
Yeah, great. So good morning to everyone on this Sunday morning. We are here to have a session on how to prepare for GPAT, the guidance series that we have started with all the toppers, GPAT toppers of previous years. We would be having 10 such sessions, which would be not subject specific, but generally about how to prepare for GPAT and all. And this is the start of this particular series. Almost like, you know, every month we would have two such separate sessions by different experts who would be guiding us on different aspects of GPAT as such. So this is a general session. I welcome all the students of Pharma Aptitude who have joined for this particular session, the online GPAT classes, as well as the students of Pharma Literacy online GPAT test series. And also we have some students from NCID Stirling's Institute of Pharmacy today to take part of for this particular session as such. So we welcome everyone for this particular session, and for providing you the guidance today, we have Mr. Kaustubh Pawar. Kaustubh is like, you know, I would say know him almost since a year now. Kaustubh ranked 2, All India ranked 2 in GPAT 2018. He's doing his master's at ICT, MPharm in pharmaceutics at ICT. And he's about to finish his master's now. He was the first ranker in all years of BPharm. That's kind of, I would say, an achievement. So he did his UG at MIT World University School of Pharmacy. He was ranked among top 5 throughout his BPharm in Pune University. He did his UG in Pune University. If you can see at the backdrop of Kaustubh, there is this name called Pharmascopy. He runs a wonderful Instagram page. And of course, he has also planned his online classes as well with the same name, I believe, for GPAT. He runs that as an Instagram page, which is exclusively for the GPAT, NIPER and ICT preparation as such. He was also awarded best outgoing student by MIP Pune as such. He has delivered various sessions in different colleges about on GPAT preparation, as well as some of his videos also are also available on some of the YouTube channels. You can go through that as well. He was also joint secretary with IPA Student Forum Pune branch during 2016 and 2017. So this is a brief background about Kaustubh. And so the intent of this particular session is to a general guidance about the preparation of GPAT. Kaustubh, for your information, we have most of the students who have just started with the preparation. They are mostly coming from the third year, as well as we have some students who already started preparation 6 months back or a year back, who are into final year currently, and they would be many of these would be appearing GPAT 2021. So welcome, Kaustubh, to this particular session. And I take this privilege to hand this over to you. Over to you. Students, if you have any question at any point of time, put it under the chat box. I have muted everyone. At the end of the session, we may take all these questions one by one. Yes, Kaustubh, over to you.
Yeah, thank you, sir, for such a wonderful introduction. So hello everyone, good morning. So let's begin with the today's session. Yeah. So let's start. So today's session will be, I'm going to tell about the preparation strategies for GPAT and as well as for other competitive exams, as well as for the semester exams, which everyone has to pass to get a degree. So let's start. So first of all, before starting your preparation or before beginning your journey of your GPAT preparation, you would have to basically, first of all, know what's your motivation. That's like the key factor which will sustain you throughout your journey of 1 and 1.5 year of studies. So why do you want to do it? What is the motivation behind it? What's the inspiration you want to struggle so far to get an All India rank? So I will tell my personal experience, what motivated me to go through such journey. So it was basically while my 12th boards, I performed very poorly. I was disappointed. I let down my family. So that was the motivation which boosted me throughout the 4 years to study hard, to work hard, and to prove myself throughout the BPharm as well as in the All India in the GPAT exam and to get an All India rank. So before beginning your journey, you have to set your goal, set a target. What do you want to achieve after studying so much, after passing this journey? So do you want to get an All India rank or just you want to qualify? So if your goal is to qualify only, then you might or might not qualify. But if your goal is to get an All India rank, then you will definitely qualify with a good rank as well as good marks. So that's most important. So what was my goal? While in third year, I decided that I want to score above 300. Usually it is a 500 marks GPAT exam. So I want to score above 300. Why is it so? So till 2017, on an average, 260 was the highest mark which an topper got in a GPAT. So if I score above 300, eventually I will get among top three. So it's my philosophy that I believe if you aim gold, if you aim a gold medal, then you will land up with the silver. And if you want a gold medal, then you should aim for a world record. So aim high, then you will achieve it. So this is why you want to do it. So fix your goal, fix your target, have a good motivation, which will sustain you throughout the journey. So let's move to the next step, which is how to prepare for GPAT examination. So we all know in our GPAT syllabus, there are 20 subjects. We have to learn or revise each and every subject. And basically this syllabus is same for all the competitive exams which are conducted for admission, to get an admission in any institute. So there is a GPAT, there is Manipal, BITS, JSS, Bharati Vidyapeeth, each and every competitive exam has the same syllabus. Except NIPER. NIPER has the same GPAT syllabus. In addition to it, they add mental aptitude as well as the pharmacy general knowledge. So for that, you can practice mental aptitude questions online, or there are various books and you can go through the current pharmacy general knowledge. So that's the only addition part in the NIPER entrance exam. Apart from that, rest everything is same for GPAT, NIPER and other competitive exams. So as you can see, I have written, rather than being jack of all, be master of most. So why it is so? Look, now there are 20 subjects. It is a vast syllabus. You have to read and revise and learn the concepts from starting from first year to the final year. It might be case that you are poor in in few subjects. Like in my personal opinion, I am poor in pathophysiology. So rather than focusing on that, on those topics, focus on stronghold. What are your stronghold? What are your strong points? What you like, what you love to read, what you can understand easily. So apart from that pathophysiology subject, I covered all the 19 rest subjects and I was mastering that. So as I was mastering most of the subject, I would be easily solve most of the questions. So I attempted 98 questions during my GPAT, and from that 84 were correct and only 12 were wrong. 14 or 12 were wrong. So you can see, so if you know most of the topics, you are in most of the masters. So you can easily solve as much as questions correctly. And this philosophy also helped me to get an All India rank with a score of 318, which is still the second highest score standing in the GPAT history. So focus on your stronghold, improve that, and focus on it. Moving to how to prepare and start with the basics. So basically, we know there are 20 subjects. There are basic subjects which are taught in first year and second year of your semester of your college. And then the rest of the major subjects which are covered in the third year and fourth year of your college. So why to start with basics? As we all know, koi bhi building ka foundation is most important for rather than its later stages. So make your foundation strong. Start with the basics so that you will be able to learn and understand easily the later concepts which are taught in the third year, final year, which are most important from the perspective of any pharmacy. But to understand those most important subjects, you have to have a stronghold of your basics. So start with physical chemistry, organic chemistry, biochemistry, PP, dispensing pharmacy, HAP, microbiology. These subjects are taught in first year, second year. So rather than jumping directly to the major subjects while preparing for GPAT, cover these subjects, understand the basic concepts and how it will help you further, that I will show you in the next slides. So moving to the next, then after completing your minor subjects, you can move to the major subjects like pharmaceutics, say, biotechnology, medicinal chemistry, ecology, analysis, pharmacognosy. So when you know the basics like colloids, which is taught in the PP, then you will be able to understand the emulsions and suspensions which are taught in the pharmaceutics in third year, final year. So you have to correlate the basics as well as the applied pharmacy knowledge, which is taught in third and fourth year. Apart from these minor major subjects, there are allied subjects which are also in our syllabus, like jurisprudence, management. These are also equally important because there are 125 questions in GPAT. So from that 125 questions, from those 20 subjects, at least 2 to 3 questions will be asked from each subject. So every subject is important. So you have to decide on which subjects you have to focus, on which subjects you have to master. That is up to you. And it's not necessary to solve each and every question. Ye apna semester paper ka exam nahi hai. Here we have negative marks. So the trick is solve the correct questions. As much as correct questions you will solve, it will be very easy to score good marks. So moving to next point, how to prepare step by step. So why it is so important? Now you can see I have given few examples in the slide. As you can see, if you learn, if you know the concepts of organic chemistry like heterocyclic reactions, name reactions, synthesis, then it is very easy to understand the concepts of structure, SAR and synthesis which are taught in medicinal chemistry of those drugs. For an example, in third year and fourth year, you might be studying medicinal chemistry in which you have antibiotics. In antibiotics, we all know the famous is penicillin. So for understanding the structure, SAR and synthesis of penicillin, what's important to understand its basics, that is its heterocyclic ring. Now, penicillin contains the penam heterocyclic ring, which is taught in first year and second year in organic chemistry. So if you know that penam heterocyclic ring is a basic component of penicillin, then it is very easy to understand the structure of penicillin, very easy to understand the SAR, and as well as easy to synthesize. So rather than mugging up, like which most of the students do, understand the basics and the concepts which you can correlate with the major topics. Apart from that, the another example is of colloids. In colloids, which are taught in physical pharmacy in first year or second year might be, we have concepts of surfactants. Now there are two famous surfactants. There is a SPAN and there are TWIN. We all know that SPAN are used to make O by W emulsion, W by O emulsions, and TWIN are used to make the O by W emulsions. We all know this concept, but why it is so? Why they are used for that? That concept is important. Like SPANs are monosterols. SPANs are monosterols, and monosterols are lipophilic in nature. They are lipophilic in nature. That's why they are used to prepare water by oil emulsion. And on the contrary, we use TWINs to make oil by water emulsion. Now, why it is so? Because they are made up of polyoxyethylene monosterols. So as monosterate is a lipophilic moiety, when we add hydroxyl or polyoxyethylene moieties to make a twin, its hydrophilicity increases. So when its hydrophilicity increases, it is very easy to make a oil by water emulsions. So if you know these concepts, the basic fundamental concepts, then it is easy to remember the points or the bulletin points. And likewise, the questions will be asked in the GPAT. GPAT questions won't be a straightforward questions. It will be applied questions. So that's why you have to know the basic concepts. Similarly, if you know the diseases which are taught in pathophysiology and the human anatomy, then it is very easy to know the concepts of our pharmacological drugs. So if you know how the bacterial infection spreads, its pathophysiology, then it will be very easy to know the mechanism of action of penicillin, the antibiotics. And when you know the mechanism of action of penicillin, it will be very easy to remember the its drug of choice. Why penicillin is a drug of choice of syphilis? Because it efficiently acts on those microorganisms and its ADR. So likewise, you have to connect starting from the basics of first year, second year to the major topics. Then rather than mucking, you will be able to cover as much as portion as possible. And it will be very easy journey for you. And the last example I would like to take is biopharm. Now, biopharm is taught in final year. Most of students think that biopharm is difficult, but they lack the knowledge that the basics of biopharm is taught in PP, in kinetics, in dosage form in Sutics, and ADM in Cology. So if you know all these three basic concepts of PP, Sutics, and Cology, then it is very easy to know the biopharmaceutical aspects. For example, there are first order reactions, second order reactions, which are taught in physical chemistry. Then we learn about emulsions or injections, tablets, different dosage form in Sutics. And in Cology, there is a general pharmacology chapter where we learn about ADME. So if you know that injections from the Sutics part, if we know its kinetics, then it will be very easy to know the compartment model of that dosage form, which is an important aspect of biopharmaceutics. So like this, you have to read. Like this, you have to learn. So stop mugging up and start actually learning the concepts and applicability of those concepts. It will be very easy to crack the GPAT as well as to get All India rank. Then moving to next topic, which is of time management. Like each and every student ask me this question, how to manage our time? We have our semesters, we have our college studies, we have our college, then we have to enjoy, we have to watch movies, then we have to take rest, we have to WhatsApp, we have to Instagram, we have Facebook. Then apart from this, later on we get a time to study for GPAT or any competitive exam. So beta, kuch paane ke liye kuch sacrifice karna padta hai. Utna bhi nahi, just 2 to 3 hours every day is sufficient to get a good, to qualify as well as to get a All India rank. So how can you manage your time throughout the 1 and 1.5 years? I personally feel that you should start your preparation from third year. So you will get 1 to 1.5 years. So you can allot 5 months to the minor subjects, 5 to 6 months for the major subjects, and remaining November, December, January for 2 to 3 months for revision. So if you allot like this, it will be very easy to complete entire 20 subjects, entire syllabus of the GPAT, NIPER, and any other competitive exam. Now, how to manage your time on the daily basis? Like, it's very important to study daily. I personally studied 2 to 3 hours daily. So there are few students who study for 5 to 6 hours once a week. So rather than studying like that, study bit by bit. So study for 2 hours or 3 hours every day, but for whole week. So that will be very easy for you to complete your syllabus. And most important is for minor subject and major subjects, for minor, only 1 to 2 weeks are essential to complete a minor subjects. Now what happens if a student takes a PP and it reads for months and months? So if he consumes a whole month, then it will affect his another subjects. So rather than reading the entire syllabus which we practice for semester exams, here key is you have to learn important points or bulletin points or the actual concept or the formulas or the sums which are asked in GPAT. So that can be covered in 1 to 2 weeks, and for major subjects 3 to 4 weeks is sufficient. So like this, you can manage your time. After managing your time, we can move to next aspect, which is how to prepare. So while preparing, I used to have one technique. So every student has a different technique to study. The most efficient technique which I like or which I used while my GPAT preparation is take a topic. If you want to study a colloids, take that topic, study and note down the important points and the concepts. After understanding that concept, go and discuss that concept with your friends and explain those concepts to your friends. So when you will do this, when you will discuss and explain to someone else, it will be very easy to remember it, to understand the concept. Because when you explain, you know that concept and you to try to simplify that concept and it is permanently embedded in your mind. So why every teacher know the concept? Why? Because they're teaching for years and years, and when they are teaching, it is very easy to remember those points. So study a topic, then discuss with your friends and then explain those concepts. And the most essential is go and practice those questions. We have n number of books for GPAT, like there is Inamdar, Muhammad Ali, Piyush, various test series are conducted by various institutes. So go and practice those questions, because practice makes man perfect. So when you will solve those questions, you will get a fair idea that how questions are asked in GPAT, which will be the correct answer and which won't be. So go and practice. I personally practice around 2000 questions of each subject from each and every book which is available and from the test series which were available back then. So after solving those question, I was pretty sure jo bhi question aaye jaise bhi aaye ghuma ke aaye seedha aaye I will be able to handle it. So practice those questions. Now students say when they practice they might get wrong. So when they get wrong answer, they get disappointed. But then why to get disappointed? It's a great opportunity to learn. When you will get a wrong question while practicing, you can revise those topic, and after revising that topic, it will be permanently embedded in your mind. So go and practice. Galat hua to galat hua, phir se usko revise karo, then it will be correct. Then next point is notes. Every student asks me this question: do we have to take notes? By taking notes is a big lengthy process. I personally feel that taking notes or the process or the technique which a student utilizes is it varies from person to person. But I prefer to take notes, because at the end, while revising, those notes will be handy to you. That will be very much easy. At that time, it will be easy to revise each and every topic. So I personally used to take notes, but there is a trick for taking notes. You have to take bulletin points, only bulletin points. Not like you have to, it's not like when you write a semester exam. In semester exam, we write each and every word. It's not the case in the GPAT preparation. If you prepare for GPAT or any competitive exam, you have to prepare for bulletin points, important concepts, which I will show in my next slide. So these are my few notes which I used to take out while preparing. So in the first figure, as you can see, I have made notes of heterocyclic synthesis. Now in this, the entire reaction is not essential. The key point is the reactant, intermediate, the catalyst and the end product. So if you know all the three aspects of a synthesis, it will be very easy to recollect at the point of examination. So like this, you can make charts, you can make various tables of heterocyclic synthesis and various name reactions, which will be very easy to remember. So the next figure, you can see there are various formulas. So these all formulas are of biochemistry, biopharmaceutics, because in biopharmaceutics, every year they ask one calculation sum. It will be about volume of distribution, about clearance, about we can say T half value. So in a single pick, you can see I have mentioned each and every formula which is important for biopharmaceutics. So like this, you can make a graph or a table or a flow chart, which will be very easy to remember. So there are some other examples. So as you can see, we all have to remember the IR values and NMR values in for pharmaceutical analysis. So it's very tough to remember the IR values and NMR values each and every, but there is a trick. So if you can plot a line graph of those IR values and mention each IR value on that line graph, then you can visualize that line graph while attempting that question, and it will be very easy to remember and recollect those IR values. For example, carbonyl has an IR value in 1700, whereas CH single bond at 2928 and C triple bond CH above 30,000, about 3,000. So if you can visualize this line graph like this, it will be very easy to remember all the IR values. So like this, you have to make notes. Let's take an example of pharmacognosy. We all know pharmacognosy is a very dry subject. We have to literally remember each and every point of that pharmacognosy. Now it is the case. We can't do anything about that, but we can smartly study those. So how we can do? Make a table. Now you can see here, I have made a table of stomata. Now you can see parasitic stomata. There are three plants, herbal drugs, which contains parasitic stomata. One is senna, coca, like this. Then there are diacetic stomata. So you can make a table or a flowchart in which you can make this likewise notes, which will be very handful while revising as well as recollecting those topics while examination. So these were the notes. Then moving to the next point, where are mnemonics and tricks? So there are various mnemonics and various tricks to remember those lengthy tables or important points. So this is these are my few posts which I posted on my Pharmascopy Instagram page, where I update the notes and the important points for GPAT and IPAR preparation. So as you can see here, we all know we have to remember the ADR or toxicity of tetracycline. So how we can easily remember those? We all know Kapil Dev. So we can associate that Kapil Dev mnemonic with the ADR tetracycline. Likewise, if in the case of Kapil Dev, K stands for kidney failure, A stands for anabolic effect, P stands for photosensitivity, I stands for insipidus diabetes. So likewise, you can remember these mnemonics. And when a question comes in a GPAD or any NIPAR exam, what is the ADR of tetracycline? And there will be four options. One will be kidney failure, renal failure, CS toxicity, and CVS toxicity. So what will be the correct answer? Kidney failure. So at that point, if you know the mnemonics, it will be very easy to mark the correct answer. Then there is a next figure which shows the drug of choice of various seizures. So likewise, you can make your own tables. I have mentioned each and every seizure which is mentioned in the book and which is the drug of choice for that seizure. As you can see, valproate is almost for six seizures drug of choice. So likewise, the question will be for absent seizure, which is the drug of choice? There will be questions of there will be options of valproate, ACTH, diazepam, and lorazepam, and the correct answer will be valproate. So at that time, you would be easily able to recollect the correct answer because you have studied smartly. So likewise, you can prepare mnemonics, tricks, tables, flowchart, memory diagrams. Then the next is how to manage semester as well as GPAD. Everyone has to prepare for semester. Everyone has to qualify and pass the semester to get a degree. And everyone has to qualify GPAD and get a good rank to get an admission in MPharm. So both are equivalent and both are equally important. It is like the 12th. In 12th, we have to prepare for boards as well as we have to prepare for JE or NEET or CET. So it's the same case. We cannot spare any one of them. So in this case, what we can do? As we all know, we have same syllabus for semester as well as for GPAD. So in this, the key point or the trick is that while preparing for semester, prepare for GPAD. For semester, there are questions of theoretical knowledge. So we have to write long and long answers of the in semester paper. But then in GPAD, there are applied questions. So the applied questions will be like mention the DOC for methicillin staphylococcus infection or calculate the volume of distribution or which surfactant is used for O by W emulsion. So likewise, questions will be asked in GPAD, which are application based. So for so how to study them while preparing for a semester? When you will study a subject, a topic, example, if you take a colloid. So when you are studying colloids for a semester exam, at that time only, mark the important and key points which might be asked in GPAD examination, like which surfactant is used for which for making which emulsion, which surfactant has which HLB value. Like this, you can make notes at that time only. So you can cover both semester as well as GPAD preparation at the same point. Then moving to what to study. So till now, we saw why to study, how to study, and now let's see what exactly we have to study. Now it's important. It's not like semester exam. We don't have to read and learn each and every line from the reference book. Study smart, because it's very important to know all the important and bulletin concepts and the points which are asked in GPAT. So that's the important points. Don't just work hard, but study smart. Work hard as well as study smart. So if you know which are the important points or important concepts which are repeated in the GPAT examination each and every year, at least since 2010. So if you analyze each and every question, if you solve each and every previous question paper, then you will be able to know which are the important concepts which they like to ask. Now the famous example is of schedules. Every year they ask schedules, they ask sterilization technique, they ask NMR numericals, they ask structure and synthesis, they ask manufacturing equipment. So if you focus on those important points, important concept, it will be very easy to score good marks. So this is the key, study smart. Then moving to next step, what I used to do, I used to study similar topics together, because we have 20 subjects and each and every subject is interlinked with each other. Like for example, when you study colloids in PP, that is interlinked with the suspension emulsions of Sutics as well as dispensing pharmacy. So when you sit to study, then at that time study these topics at the same time. So in a one go, you will be able to complete most of the topic from the different subjects. Similarly, carbohydrates, amino acids are from organic chemistry, is mentioned in biochemistry as well as in cognacy. So when you will study these topics, study each and every topic from organic, bio and cognacy of carbohydrate and amino acid. So in a single go, you will be able to complete three different subjects. Similarly, ecology and medicinal chemistry, it's meant to be studied together. Unlike what we are taught in our colleges, they are taught separately, but it's not the case. If you want to learn actually the pharmacological drug or the allopathic drug, you have to study medicinal chemistry and ecology together, because when you know a mechanism of action of a penicillin, you have to know its SAR, what components or what chemical moieties affects its activity. Then after knowing those, you have to know its adverse drug reactions and drug of choice, which is being studied in clinical pharmacy. So study these subjects together. It will be very easy to remember, revise and understand those concepts. And the last and most important point is solve previous year question papers. Because as I said, most of the time important topics gets repeated. Like for antiarrhythmatics, antiarrhythmatics from last 5 years, they have asked one question from antiarrhythmatics. So when you will solve those questions, there are various books, like there is Inamdar, most famous and everyone follows it. Apart from ekbar Inamdar khatam ho gaya solve karke, then you move to another topics, like there is a Pearson, then there is Piyush, then there is Muhammad Ali, then there are various test series. So you can solve those test series. So this was what to study. Then let's see what are the important weightages. So basically from 2019, when NTA entered, they have bifurcated the GPAT in five or four separate sections. So one section is allotted for pharmaceutics and its allied subjects, which is about 20 to 25% weightage they have given to that. Then there is a pharmacological section, which consists of clinical pharmacy, HAP, as well as pathophysiology. Then there is medicinal chemistry, organic chemistry, physical chemistry, all chemistry section. And then there is analysis and pharmacognosy. So likewise, this is the weightage from 2019 they have started asking like this. So as you can see, I have highlighted few of the subjects which are most important. These are the major subjects. From this, definitely half of the questions will be there. It's important to study pharmaceutics, physical pharmacy, micro biopharm, ecology, clinical pharmacy, medicinal organic chemistry, analysis, and we cannot spare wo to dead end rahega hi, pharmacognosy. So we have to study these important topics, because half of the from 125 questions, half of the questions will be from these subjects. So if you if you will study these subjects, your half of the GPAT preparation will be done. Then moving to final year, there are few final year students which are going to appear in 2021 for GPAT. If they are going to start from this session after watching my session, still you can qualify, still you can get your good marks. How you can do? Now we have 6 months in our hand. We can allot 5 months to study and last 1 month for revision. Now in this case, rather than focusing on those 20 subjects, focus on the important topics from those 20 subjects, which I have highlighted in this slide. Like from Pology, every year they will ask classification, they will ask mechanism of action, DOC, ADR. For this, you can refer Sposh Gupta, Rangandel. These are quite handy books for this. So like for medicinal chemistry, SAR structure synthesis, isme se do teen questions rahenge hi. Likewise, for sootics, tablets, NDDS, aerosols, emulsions, pre-formulations. Similarly, for analysis, there will be a couple of questions from IR and NMR. From Cognosy, they ask a tabular form, like they ask, they gave us the pharmacognostic drug, then they asked to match them with the clinical use as well as its CC and CT. So likewise, so if you will read and revise those important topics which are asked in GPAT frequently, it will be very easy to prepare even within the 6 months. So these are few of the minor subjects which they like to ask from PPPC. They like to ask from micromeritics, rheology, colloids. You can take a screenshot of this. It will be very handy for you. Then from jurisprudence, they will definitely ask schedules. And schedule Y is most favorite of them, because here the trick is that schedule Y has two important criteria. One, schedule Y is used for clinical trial guidelines, as well as schedule Y is for import guidelines. So this in detail you should know, rather than reading briefly, read in depth. So likewise from dispensing pharmacy, there will be question from allegation and calculation. Likewise, these are all the highlighted topics are most frequently asked in GPAT as well as NIPER exam. Then at the end, I would like to tell which books I prefer. So in this, I have listed the books which I preferred during my GPAT examination, and the highlighted one is Indian Pharmacopoeia and USP. Most of the students don't follow up that. But it's the most important aspect of any pharmaceutical competitive exam or even for semester exam, because it's ideal to learn limits, evaluation tests which are asked in the GPAT from Indian Pharmacopoeia, because that is the original source. It has been correct. And while preparing those questions, the examiner will make those questions by referring the IP and USP. So if you want to study limits, evaluation test, or manufacturing techniques, sterilization techniques, its limits, then please refer IP and USP. Apart from that, nowadays they are going to ask ICH guidelines. Every year, at least one ICH guideline has been asked from last 5 years. So go and at least know which are the important ICH guidelines. Likewise, so these are the reference books. Apart from reference books, for revision, at the end, you can refer Pearson. They have beautifully given the important aspects in a bulletin points. So at that time, you can refer Pearson. And for question papers, there is Inamdar. So these were the books which I referred. Then moving to at the end, I would like to thank Pharma Elite and the sir to inviting me. And I personally believe in the philosophy in the three idiots dialogue ki success ke piche mat bhago, excellence ka picha karo, success jhak maar ke tumhare piche aayega. Because I preferred to be excellent in pharmacy when I was preparing for my bachelor's as well as for the GPAT. The goal was there, but I didn't focus on that. I focused on the process. I focused to become excellent in what I am reading, what I am practicing. And eventually I got an All India rank too. And I am here in front of you delivering a session on GPAT and how I prepared. So thank you, sir.
Yes, thank you so much, Kaustav. It was indeed a great session. Students, any questions before I...